was asked the other day about Cork and how to periodize about Cork. So Sam here, our new student from DCU, is going to be recording this. Sam's behind the camera. just going to run through this real quick. So basically, just split up into three levels. You have someone who's a beginner who hasn't done any core work or any sports specific work or strength and condition. Then you have an intermediate and advanced. And someone in advanced would be someone sort of like as an Olympic lifter or something, or even a full-time athlete. So we're just going to run through basic exercises for each. And then if you have any more questions or if you want any sort of links, advisable links to the actual core work for your level, you can send it out. So we're just going to run through first, anyone who's a beginner, just starting off, so basic plank, just using an isometric contraction, just getting used to your core and being familiar with all the muscles in your core and so forth. So just basic plank is down on the floor, starting off, elbows directly underneath the shoulders, forearms should be touching the ground, not just going through your elbows, okay? So forearms on the ground, keeping the weight over and pushing forward. Feet, hip width apart, and then squeeze that one point here that you really need to do to activate all the core. Squeeze the glutes as hard as you can, as if you're holding a lottery ticket in between your butt cheeks. So squeeze as hard as you can, and then suck your belly button, keeping that back nice and flat. Okay, so once you hold that position, if you're squeezing your glutes, you can feel it running up the core, then you're doing it right. Go into more detail about that, but we just want to run through each exercise. To advance the plank, also you can do simply up on one foot for 10 seconds, switch up on the other foot. You can also do different movements side to side, getting more of a preformance in on the glutes. And then also you can do side plank, holding up, one foot up. So just play around with a little. Second exercise then you can do is more dynamic movements to do with the core. I always like to keep the lower back in contact with the floor though, doing any sort of dynamic move. So this exercise I'll show you now. Simply have a partner stand over you, or else you can hold onto something solid. So simply lying down, hold onto the kettlebell. So this will be more sort of intermediate exercise. Feet 6 inches off the floor. In this position, you're pushing your lower back into the floor so that there shouldn't be an arch. Push your lower back into the floor, squeeze the core, okay? From here, 6 inches off the ground, raise your feet up, push the lower back in, drop them, catch them before they hit the floor, okay? Make it more difficult to change direction as well. Okay, you can see my lower back is coming slightly off the floor, so just be a little bit more controlled. And to make that even more hard to advance that, have a partner stand over you, holding their ankles, and you bring your feet up, have them push your feet away, and you catch them before they hit the floor. So that's an intermediate exercise. Then a more advanced exercise to put more weight to the core, just over here real quick, is a hanging guard arm. So you actually can do a staple of the core if you're being doing sit-ups or whatever, plank for quite a period of time. You could do a program like this movement from plank, to hanging leg raises, working with a partner, to guard arms, also back extension of key. So guard arm is simply hanging from the pull-up bar, toes pointed up forward, up, dorsiflexion position, knees up, parallel from here, get your knees to your chest, back down, nice and up, okay, again, more advanced movement, change direction. Okay, so basic one, knees up. You can do that for 20 to 25 reps, okay? Want more advanced than that one, you can either add weight to your ankles or dumbbell around, do it for lower reps, or else do straight leg raises, up and control down, keep the chin tucked, engage those lats, okay? So again, 20 to 25 reps. Again, back extension is very important, but plank, then some sort of movement with leg raises and stuff, using dynamically, and then moving on to sort of guard hammers. Core is like any sort of exercise, you need to periodize it and also need to move through this sort of program where your core will always be strengthened and then movement in a dynamic position. So.